am young, yet my story is 90 years old. I saw Lebanon develop, grow and flourish, and my memory is deeply rooted in the memory of this country. Stemming from a long banking tradition, I am the offspring of a marriage between two banks. For 90 years, I remained faithful to my clients, faithful to my country. I remained young, and I am the first registered bank in Lebanon. I am Francebank. At the turn of the last century, the silk industry was the main economic activity in the country. More than half of the population worked in 183 factories spread out in Mount Lebanon. More than 90% of their produce was exported to France. To promote the industry and facilitate the work of traders who were in frequent contact with foreign counterparts, Banque Sabah was established. It is one of the two banks from which I originated. In 1921, the French mandate over Lebanon began. That year, the Crédit Foncier d'Algérie de Tunisie, CFAT, started its operations in Beirut. It is the second bank from which I originated. Modernization accelerated, and CFAT played an important role, mainly in the agricultural sector. It provided Lebanese farmers with loans and helped develop and finance several industries, including the establishment of Régie du Tabac. Beirut, the capital, flourished. Architects built and developed the city. In 1933, the CFAT participated, among other banking institutions, in financing the construction of the famous Hotel St. George. In the same period, Gibran Tweni founded the daily newspaper An-Nahar, a main pillar of Lebanese media. An-Nahar was financed by Banque Sabah. On the 22nd of November 1943, Lebanon declared its independence. The country prospered in all fields. It became a source of artistic and cultural innovation, as well as the financial hub of the Middle East. Lebanon thrived. While everywhere in the Arab world, people were drawn towards socialism. Meanwhile, the brothers, Adnan and Adel Kassar, grew up in a peaceful home in the heart of Beirut. Their father was a well-known and highly respected judge. Their mother, a woman of principles, raised them to value mutual support and brotherhood. Values that had a determining influence on their future. In 1968, Israel bombed the airport of Beirut in retaliation for the attack by the Popular Front for the Liberation of Palestine on an El Al airplane in Athens. Lebanon was in shock. 13 civilian airplanes were destroyed. Almost half of these airplanes belonged to the Lebanese International Airways, which consequently went bankrupt. Banque Sabah, which had financed the company, was shaken by this event. Following the wave of nationalism in Tunisia and Algeria, CFAT retreated to France. It sold all its branches in Lebanon to the Banque Française pour le Moyen-Orient. In 1975, what came to be known as the Civil War erupted in Lebanon. The city was divided and the country battered. The industrial and banking sectors were destabilized. In order to overcome the crisis, new alliances were created. The Ando-Suez Group facilitated the merger between Banque Sabah and the Banque Française pour le Moyen-Orient. The merger was sealed in 1978. All this while, the brothers Kassar were quickly progressing in life. In 1954, their father was assigned as ambassador of Lebanon to Pakistan. The brothers took this opportunity to explore China and the Chinese market. At that time, venturing into China was a daring act. Their efforts were rewarded, and the Kassar Group established 36 commercial outlets for importing Chinese goods to the Middle East. In 1978, while Lebanon was still in turmoil, the Ando-Suez Group decided to sell France Bank.
كنا بوقتها في خضم الاستيراد والتصدير والتجارة الحقيقة ما كانت خاطرة بفكرنا.
رأسا رياكشن قلت له نحن بنشتري.
وقتها مانعوا شوي.
واجهتنا صعوبات بالأول لحتى لي البنك المركزي وافق لنا على الشراء.
أخذت سنتين يعني أخذوا عطا.
إجوا قالوا لنا هيدا أقدم بنك، هيدا عنده أكبر عدد فروع، هيك بتكون تيجي بتشتري يعني هيك. كتير تعذبنا.
وتم الاتفاق، اشترينا وقتها بسنة 1980.
The bank settled on Hamra Street, in the same building as the old Banque Sabah. The building was designed in 1966 by the world-renowned Finnish architect Alvar Aalto.
When we took the agreement, the most important thing was the preservation of the existing.
We were hungry to learn.
The subject remains the same as it is. الإدارة ما بيتحرك فيها حدا.
زتينا حالنا لنكتسب أكثر شيء ممكن.
الله يرحمه المدير العام حبيب نوفل إجا قال خذ مكتبي، قلت له أعوذ بالله ولا يمكن. أخذت مكتب قد نص مكتبه لأنه هيدا كان موجود.
انغمسنا اثنيناتنا فيه بكل قوانا وبكل إمكانياتنا.
وين في عنا آراء جديدة للتحسين؟ نجي نحنا نطرح عليكم وبيكون في تشاور نحنا وياكم.
فتحنا بعلبك، فتحنا بجنوب، محلات يلي كان ما حدا يفكر فيها بوقتها وكانت ايام حرب. بس عنا كان فكره توسعيه، راسا نزلنا فيها وتجاوبوا معنا الموجودين بالبنك.
Despite the events in Lebanon, the bank proved to be strong and resilient. However, when many Lebanese fled the battles that inflamed Beirut, and in order to remain faithful to its clients, France Bank decided to follow them. It settled on the banks of the Lake Leman in Geneva and took shares in Françard's Capital, a large Swiss and European banking group. In June 1982, Israel invaded Lebanon. Defying the chaotic atmosphere, France Bank opened a new branch in Nabatieh on the 6th of July 1982. A year later, the Kassar brothers, determined to expand their business, contacted the Crédit Agricole and invited it to subscribe to their capital.
قالولي بس نحنا بعدنا هلا ناشئين، يعني صحيح بنك كبير كل التعاونيات بحجما، بس ما عندنا كثير اتصالات دولية. قلت لهم طيب أنا برجع بعد سنة. هيدي تعلمناها من الصين، ما تقطع الأمل وخذ الوقت. فجينا بعد سنة رجعت لعندهم.
بعتبر الإنجاز هذا من كمان من أكبر الإنجازات. ليش؟ أهميته كانت إنه تقدر تجيب مؤسسة عالمية كالكريدي أجريكول تدخل بنك لبناني. سنة الـ 84 بعز الحرب كانوا عم يخطفوا الفرنساوية يجوا لحديت بيروت ليتباحثوا معنا ويقتنعوا منا.
قصة الواحد يعني بيفكر فيها بيقول هل كانت معقولة هالشيء؟ بس بده يكون الواحد عنده الإيمان ويقول أنا بدي أوصل.
In September 1984, Crédit Agricole subscribed to the capital of Françabank. Françabank opened in Paris its first affiliated bank. In 1986, Françabank opened a representative office in Hong Kong. In 1988, it opened another bank, this time in Zaire. On the 13th of October 1990, the fighting came to an end. The country had to be rebuilt. Françabank was there for this task. In September 1994, Françabank launched its first Lebanese leasing company. The bank rented out machines to various sectors of the economy. This provided contractors with the necessary equipment without having to invest heavily and thus accelerated reconstruction work. Françabank also established a specialized investment company, the França Invest Bank.
مصرفي عنده بصير نظرة شاملة على الاقتصاد بمجمله. بصير بتقدر تنقي القطاع اللي بدك انت تنميه او تكبره. تشوف أي هو بفيد البلد حتى تقدر تجي تساعده أكثر من غيره. عندك إنبوت يعني بتقدر تجي تجيب شيء منك أنت حتى تفيد بلدك.
On the 18th of September 1995, the German Investment and Development Company, one of the largest financial establishments in the world, participated with as much as 5% in Françabank's capital.
عادة بيفوتوا بيقعدوا 3-4 سنين بيربحوا وبيروحوا. لهم معنى هلا اكثر من 30 سنه، عدلوا قوانينهم الداخليه ليبقوا معنا لانه مبسوطين. ودخلنا معنا شركاء كمان من العالم العربي، مؤسسه التامينات الكويتيه، مؤسسه ضخمه جدا. صار البنك عنده اساس مساهمين دوليين، هيدي بنعتز فيها ونحن من الاوائل فيها هيدي.
The bank dedicated itself to the reconstruction of Lebanon, consolidated its base, and continued to expand. Within 12 years, Françabank has acquired 7 banking establishments. At the same time, the bank established over 7 affiliated companies. In such a short period of time, Françabank has grown and expanded its international reach. France, the first international entity for Françabank established in 1984. Algeria, the first and only Lebanese bank to enter the Algerian market. Sudan, an Islamic bank with international and regional partners and shareholders. Syria, a growing network that reached 9 branches within 2 years. Belarus, the first and only Lebanese bank in this promising Eastern European market. Cyprus, through BLC Bank, a subsidiary of the Françabank Group. With such fast progress, we cannot but wonder, what is the secret?
العنصر البشري أنا برأيي هو شيء أساسي أساسي أساسي. دونك هيدا يلي بيجي بمكن مؤسسة تنمى وتكبر. مشان هيك بنعطي أهمية كبيرة كتير للعنصر البشري بتنقايته بتدريبه بتمكينه أنه يعتبر انتمائه للمؤسسة يصير يعتبر حاله عائلة وحدة.
In record time, France-Banque has reached far. What does the future hold? What is the vision?
الإنجاز هو العمل اليومي كمان. متابعة الأمور كلها بشكل عام. ويكون الواحد منفتح. منفتح كمان للتغيير، للتحسين. ما يعتبر هو إنه وصل للشيء اللي هو السمم يلي خلاص، لا.
البنك مثل ما شايفينه عم يكبر بطريقة مسلة وما فيها تعركوج. دونك برأينا بالطريقة اللي نحن ماشيين فيها إن شاء الله بأيامنا أو أيام غيرنا بيصير بالبنك الأول